Whoa, there's a line here going on. Okay, guys. Once you put in your money, go ahead and sit down on the stairs. Perfect. Good morning. My name is Miriam Blackerby, or Miss Blackerby, if you guys know me from school, or Mom, if you know me from home. So this morning, I want to ask you guys a question, but my kids are not allowed to answer. Does anybody know where I am from? Okay, I am not from Chile, but that's a good guess. Okay, Gael. I am from Peru. Okay, so I obviously now live in the States, but I didn't always live in the States. I was actually 10 years old, going on 11, when I moved to the United States. And when we came to the United States, we didn't come to California directly. We didn't know this wonderful place called California existed. So we went to the East Coast, which is cold. And it's different. When we went there, I didn't speak any English. My dad came to help another. My dad was a pastor in Peru, and he came to help another pastor, and we lived in Boston. And when we moved here, we didn't really know anybody at all. And I remember coming here, we were just so excited because we were going to another country, and it was the United States, and everybody went to the United States, thought it was wonderful. So I was really excited. I remember getting my first pair of jeans, because they're expensive in Peru, but we were traveling, so we were gonna wear jeans. And we came here and we didn't understand a word anybody was saying. So when we came to the States, since we didn't know anybody, my dad didn't really have a job. We didn't have a place to live. It was a little scary. But I remember always having like this. My dad always said, like, God is going to take care of us, And so we got here and we lived in this pastor's house for a little bit. And then we were looking for apartments, but we didn't know. Well, first of all, we didn't really have any income. So we didn't really know where we were going to live. And then suddenly a church member goes, there's an apartment in my apartment building. So I don't know, like magically, we suddenly had an apartment, and then we moved into our apartment. It was this apartment that I think had like 2 bedrooms, and there was no furniture. But we were so excited because we had our own place. And then my dad was like, well, we'll just get stuff as we go along. And it was fine. It was like camping, which we didn't really do camping when we were in Peru. So we were like, it was like camping and it was exciting. And then one weekend, a bunch of church members showed up with a furniture. So our apartment was furnished. And then other people from our church showed up with food. And at Christmas time, someone showed up with a tree and gifts for all of us. It was a very humbling moment knowing that, God really does take care of us. So God in the Bible doesn't say that if you follow him, everything's gonna be easy. It was still hard. We still had to learn the language. We still had to find jobs. My dad still had to do things that he was a professor in Peru, and he was a pastor, and he still had to shovel snow to earn money. It was still a difficult time. We had to learn the language. We didn't know anything. I had to repeat a grade because I didn't know the language. So they put me back in sixth grade, and I was like, I've already done sixth grade. I don't want to do sixth grade again. And they were like, well, you know, you have to have some time to learn how to speak the language, and I'm still learning. But even though things were difficult and hard, God gave us what we needed. He gave us the tools. He either gave us like a place to live so we could have shelter over our heads, or he provided us with people that would help us either find jobs or have food or have gifts for Christmas, which is really important for kids. And that's God's promise. God promises to not always things are going to be easy. So for us, like, when you guys are little, things sometimes are like, oh my goodness, that test is so difficult. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to do well on that test. But like, he already gave you the tools. You've already been preparing through like your school days so that when you get to the test, you already have the basics so that you can perform what you need to perform. So I was reading this Bible verse. We've been reading this Jesus Calling devotional with the kids. And the Bible verse is in Habakkuk 3, hold on. And it says, the Lord gives me my strength. He makes me like a deer which does not stumble. He leads me safely in the steep mountains. So he doesn't take away the mountains, but he makes you like a deer. He gives you the kind of feet that deer have so that they don't stumble when they have to go through the mountains. I don't know if you guys have been paying attention, but we've been talking about the end of times at church. Pastor's been talking about the end of times. And sometimes, I remember when I was a little kid, I'd hear the end of times and I'd be kind of scared about it, because it's an exciting time because Jesus is coming. But you know, there's all of these things that are happening before Jesus comes that can be a little bit scary. But God promises that he is going to give us the tools. He's going to not take away the mountains, but he's going to give us what we need so we can get through them without falling. Amen. Anyway, so now that you guys are done, please go back to your seats. Thank you.